Hello children, today we'll study about the basic structure of the cell. Every cell possesses three basic features in common, that is plasma membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. Due to the presence of these features, all activities inside the cell and interaction of the cell with its environment are possible. Plasma membrane or cell membrane. This is a thin, delicate and elastic membrane which forms the outer layer of a cell. It allows only some substances to pass through it. Therefore, it acts as a semi-permeable or selectively permeable membrane. It helps to maintain the shape of the cell. Cell wall. It is a tough, non-living covering outside the plasma membrane. It is found only in plant cells and is freely permeable. It is mainly made up of cellulose, a complex substance that provides structural strength to the plants. Nucleus. Nucleus is a spherical body present inside the cell. It is also called as the brain of the cell. It contains a thick jelly-like substance called nucleoplasm. The nucleus is separated from the rest of the cell by a nuclear membrane. The nuclear membrane is porous and allows the movement of substance between the cytoplasm and the nucleus. A small spherical structure present inside the nucleus called nucleolus plays an important role in protein synthesis. The nucleus also has a thread-like network called chromatin. The chromatin organizes itself into rod-like structures when the cell has to divide. These rod-like structures are called chromosomes. They contain the DNA inside them. The DNA forms the hereditary material in most organisms. Each molecule of DNA has several genes on it. Genes are unit of inheritance. That is, they help in transmitting the characters from parents to offsprings. Cytoplasm. Most part of the cell consists of the cytoplasm. It is a jelly-like substance inside the cell. The cytoplasm has the nucleus and various other cellular components within it. These components are called cell organelles. All metabolic activities take place within the cytoplasm and it is responsible for storing and releasing energy. Vacuoles are sac-like structures in the cell. In mature plant cells, they occupy most of the space within the cells and help to store food, water, and wastes. In addition, the vacuoles also provide turgidity to the plant cell. In animal cells, vacuoles are smaller and may be greater in number. They help in waste removal and digestion. Mitochondria, singular it is called as mitochondrion, are tiny, oval or kidney-shaped organelles found in both animal and plant cells. They oxidize the digested food in our body to produce energy. Hence, they are known as the powerhouse of the cell. Golgi bodies. They are flat, membranous, sac-like structures that are found near the nucleus of most cells. They are arranged in stacks. They are secretory organelles. They secrete substances such as enzymes and proteins. In plant cells, Golgi bodies are not well defined and are called dictyosomes. Plastids. They are disc-shaped structures present only in plant cells. They can be of three types: chloroplasts, chromoplasts, and leucoplasts. Chloroplasts. Plastids with a green-colored photosynthetic pigment chlorophyll are called chloroplasts. They are also called as the kitchen of the plant cell. Chromoplasts. Plastids with pigments other than the color green are called chromoplasts. Leucoplasts. They are colorless plastids that vary in various shapes. They store food materials such as starch, proteins, and fat. So children, today we have studied about the various parts of the cell. Hope you have enjoyed it. Thank you.